Hello, everybody. My name is Jodabeni, and I'm an electrical engineer, and I've been working for some time now, and I've been developing my software engineering skills. And I know a lot of people out there who want to become electrical engineers are the same people who also maybe want to become software engineers. And today's video, I have something very special for you. Today, someone's going to be joining us is Rami from the Black Tech Experience. He used to work at Google, Twitch, Amazon, and Dell as a software engineer. And I wanted to give you guys how I would do it, but better yet, I believe it's better if I grabbed somebody who's actually been in that same environment, the highest level of software engineering employment in the United States, that can directly give you the results and answers that you need. So now I'm gonna go ahead and pass it over to Rami. Be sure to check out his channel, The Black Tech Experience. I'm gonna leave his channel link in the comment section and the description down below. So be sure to go check him out, because we are so grateful that he's going to give us this insider on how to become a software engineer today.
Hello, my name is Robert Pruitt. I'm a software engineer. I have worked for companies such as Google, Twitch, Amazon, and Dell. Today, I have a very special video for you, which is what I would do if I had to start over as a software engineer in 2025. And this video is going to be extremely special because I'm somebody who has worked at companies like Google, as well as I have a master's degree from Cornell. So I am very informed on this topic. Some of you might be thinking that software engineer is going to be obsolete in the next 5 years. And I'll agree, and I'll say that software engineering is going to change in the next 5 years, but we're always going to need human beings to be able to write software for human beings. And I want to give a special thanks to Jodabeni, but let's get right into it. Embrace the government contracting route. When I started working at Twitch, I had a master's degree from Cornell and almost 100 grand in student debt. To my surprise, when I started working at Twitch, I met people who didn't even have a degree, but they were able to get the same salary as me. What this signifies is degrees are not as important as your work experience. Some of my friends are going to get a PhD in AI or a master's degree, and I would not recommend that unless you are extremely passionate about a certain research topic in AI. You are not going to need AI in order to start a business with it in the future. What you're going to need is experience and understanding of what businesses suck at. And your easiest way to get that is the government contracting route, because all you need to do is get certain certifications and register on certain sites, and then people will start calling you about opportunities, whether it be for just 6 months or a year overseas. It can be a great stepping stone to start your career and set you up for success over the next 3 to 4 years. Hit the road and go to career fairs. I met a woman at Twitch, and she said she went to 6 to 12 career fairs over the span of 2 years, and she was able to get a six-figure job at Twitch because of it. So you want to be leveraging your network. I've also heard of a content creator named Primogy, and he has talked about how he got a job at Netflix with no career experience because he has specialized knowledge in a technology that they were using. And so he was able to turn that into a full-time gig as a senior software engineer. Unfortunately, as time goes on, people are using AI to apply to these various different websites, and recruiters don't even look at that. They don't even look at it anymore because the AI is able to beat their algorithms in understanding who is actually a great candidate. So in order to have success today and tomorrow, what you are going to need is an expansive network. Whether that means you have to fly to various different places to get a hotel or drive out there, this is your best way to make sure that you always get the salary that you deserve, is through having a network of recruiters that you can always call on. I have many recruiters on my LinkedIn that we have worked together, and they will be willing to skip me through the line if I need it. And this is what you need to continue to build in your career as you grow.
So if you've been enjoying this video so far, be sure to hit the like button and the subscribe button. And by all means, feel free to leave a question or a comment in the comment section down below. Rami can help answer it. I can help answer it. And there's other engineers who watch this video that can help you answer it as well. And by all means, When you leave a like, it helps YouTube push it to other people just like you who are trying to get this information. So we appreciate you for watching this video, and let's keep it going.
I will move to a tech city. I am from Memphis, Tennessee, and I can tell you how hard it is to get a job when there are only 3 or 4 known tech companies in the city. And so if you're not living in a place like Seattle, Washington, California, New York, or Austin, Texas, you are playing this game on hard mode. Now that I have Twitch and Amazon on my resume, I can command a high hourly rate as a remote contractor, or I can work for a lot of remote companies. So don't make it, you don't have to live there forever if you love your hometown. But if you are somebody young in your career, I cannot stress how important it is to be open to relocating and spending a few years there. You can always move back when you're done, but I would highly recommend going to a tech city for a few years. I have a video on my channel. It's called The 10 Best Cities to Leverage the AI Wave. I would highly recommend that. Hopefully it's playing up here. I would find a mentor by giving him something for free. Many of you talk about how hard it is to find a mentor, but that's because you want someone to give you their time and their resources for free. And it's just not a balanced relationship for that mentor. I have found mentors by helping them, giving my time for free. And I'll give you an example. When I was in school, there was this professor. He worked at Google, and I helped out in his class by being his TA, which gave him a lot of pressure off because he didn't have to do everything with his students. I could be a tutor, I could grade, and it gave him an opportunity to work on the things that he was more passionate about. And although I'm not helping him with anything today, because I gave him so much, we have a rapport, we have a relationship, I could call him up whenever I need. And so that's what you should be looking for when you ask somebody to be your mentor, is that you are giving first, and then you may take. And so if you want to be mentored by me, you can go to my Patreon. I am very open to helping you in whatever avenue that you would like. But that's an excellent way how it's a balanced relationship. You win and I win. I would specialize in core technologies. Many of you think in order to be a good software engineer, you have to know many different programming languages, but that's completely opposite. In order to be a great software engineer, what you need is a strong project where you have to go deep in a language. This is far more important than knowing everything, knowing a lot about everything. There are content creators. I'll give you an example. His name is Data with Zach. He has a community where he teaches people about being a data engineer. And this guy has worked at companies like Netflix and Airbnb and Meta as a data engineer. He is a much better teacher and what it means to be a data engineer than going to get a degree from a professor. So if you want to be a software engineer, I will focus on maybe being a full stack engineer or a data engineer for 3 years. It doesn't have to be the hottest topics right now. I'm probably being a data engineer and an AI engineer. If you do that, then you are setting yourself up for success and not being a jack of all trades where you can't get positions because you're a generalist. Generalists do well in software engineering. I consider myself more of a generalist, but my specialty is being a full stack engineer. And so you want to have your specialty as well. Always learn new things. Many of the things that I learned 10 years ago in my computer science degree are obsolete today. What that signifies is that things always change. It's always happened, even with the AI that is going to come out and make many jobs obsolete over the next 2 to 3 years. We always have to continue learning new things. There are people like my father who tend to be set in their ways. They have enough experience to provide an impact in this world. But unfortunately, we're heading for a great reset where people have to relearn new skills and figure out how are they going to use the AI in order to provide value in their lives in the future. And so if you are someone who is curious, who loves to learn, is always adapting, you are going to have success regardless of whether AI takes your current job because you will be able to get the next job. AI is going to take jobs from us and it's going to create new jobs. And the only way to be ahead of the curve is to be a lifelong learner. I cannot stress that enough. Always learn new things, be curious, because change is about to come. Be gritty. Many people think that success is about intelligence, it's about connections, but the number one thing you need to have success in your career is your ability to persevere. There were many times in my career where I had to wait. I think I should have been at Twitch and Amazon 4 years earlier, but unfortunately, I had to wait because I didn't have a mentor to tell me the information that I'm telling you today about being in a tech city. And so if I had to go back and tell myself something, if I had to start over today and I had to tell myself one thing to understand about this career, is that you're going to have to persevere and be patient, because not everything comes in the right moment. However, if you work hard, you will eventually get that opportunity and you can make the most out of it. So to you, I would say be gritty, be patient. Sometimes things may not come as fast as you like, but once you get it, nobody can take it away from you. The wars are meaningful. Embrace the AI revolution. I know senior software engineers who are not using AI models to this day because they're set in their ways. They think that if you use the AI models, it's dulling your skill. And to them, I would say they're about to be blown out of the water by people who are using these AI models. Anybody who's using AI is working at a level beyond people in the past. Obviously, AI cannot do everything for you. However, it's a great for giving you the data points that you need to make the best decisions on your ideas. If you're not using AI in your job right now, you are behind. Many people are about to be beaten by the competitors that are using AI because they are not using AI. You want to be an early adopter. You want to use these AI models as much as possible, and you want to be asking them questions that you have think that they're not capable of answering correctly, because you will be quite surprised at how intelligent they are and how intelligent they are becoming. And so embrace the AI revolution. I know sometimes it's scary to see these AI models do things that are beyond what we humans are capable of, but that's all the more reason of why we need to use these tools in order to reach the outcomes that we want to reach in life. I'm somebody who enjoys coding to a certain degree, but there's some things that I dislike, and for that, I would use AI to make those repetitive tasks a lot easier. But I cannot stress enough how much you need to use AI in your job, your side projects. Use it for cooking. I don't know, but my point is embrace the AI revolution. Don't be somebody who is defeated by the AI wave. Be somebody who's riding the AI wave. There you go. That's 10 years of experience given to you in less than 10 minutes. And there's three things I would have to say to take away. Is that so much of your success depends on the people that you know, your ability to break down projects into three-year goals, as well as your ability to embrace the AI revolution by being curious and a lifelong learner. If you want to see more of me, hopefully my tags are on the screen right now, but you can find me at the Black Tech Experience, and I'll hand it back over to Jodabeni to finish the video.
So thank you so much to Rami for putting time out of his busy day to make this video for everybody here today. We really do appreciate you. And you guys hear that from someone who has 10 years of experience as a software engineer. He's worked at Google and other big companies that a lot of you inspire to be there today. So be sure to remember what he said. And if you need to rewatch this video more, multiple times over so that you can really grasp that understanding, by all means, go check it out. And if you are serious about improving your coding skills, be sure to check out the links in my comment section down below. One example is Skrima. You get 20% off by using them as a resource to better your coding skills. And on that note, I'll see you guys in the next video. Jodabeni is out.